This video provides a guide on using the EasyWeigh 7 weigh scale indicator to record individual animal weights against visual IDs. Start a new recording session. Press Menu. Scroll down to display Sessions. Press Enter twice to start a new session. The session will be recorded with the current date and time of the indicator. You are now ready to start recording weights. Weigh with visual ID. As the animal enters the crush, the EasyWeigh 7 quickly and accurately captures the weight even if the animal is still moving, and will illuminate the red stable light. The animal's visual ID can be entered through the keypad. To record a trait such as breed, you can scroll down to enter a comment using the keypad. You can then press record to store the weight and comment against visual ID. If the animal has been previously weighed and recorded in another session, its weight gain will be displayed on the information screen. When the animal moves off the platform, the indicator automatically returns to zero. You can view the statistics of the current or previous weigh sessions. Press the menu to display statistics. Scroll through the list of the statistics for the session, including the count of the number of animals weighed, the average weight, total weight, and the max and minimum weights. To view or manage the individual records, you need to download the recorded sessions to your computer. To download a recorded session file, connect the indicator to the computer using the supplied USB cable. Start the DataLink application. Check the indicator is connected as shown in the status bar. The left pane shows the sessions recorded on the indicator that are available to download. Select the applicable session to download. Select the download option. Select the location to save the session file. The desktop is usually a good place unless you have a specific folder you normally use. Once downloaded, the session records are displayed on the right of the screen. This concludes the EasyWeigh 7 how-to video for weighing with visual ID. For further information, refer to the other videos in this series, or alternatively, see the product documentation.